the hell was that about?
It's time.
I didn't get that one. I didn't get that one, Zulu. You got to explain that one to me. Okay, man. I don't like it, but I'm gonna. Right. Oh, I got you. Yeah. I remember that. Yeah. This dude.
For the NBA.
You watching this, Zula? Let me see here. Yeah, every time we try to play game two, something happens. Every time. I didn't know I was grunting. I did adjust myself in where I'm at, but I don't know if I was grunting, but maybe I was. Maybe they fixed that goaltending thing. That's what I hope they fix. Well, I saw the list of what they did, but the list that I saw was for the PC version. There's a lot of stuff they was talking about was PC. But I imagine Operation Sports, now they probably got the whole list of everything they did. If we go to Operation Sports.
Live on 2K Sports.
Yes, sir.
This is Kevin Harlan with Steve Kerr and Clark Kellogg alongside. And our sideline reporter tonight is Doris Burke. Welcome to Los Angeles. Home court advantage for the Lakers. We are live at the Staples Center. And the Clippers starting five. Blake Griffin down low and DeAndre Jordan. CP3 at point with Redick there in the backcourt. And it's Barnes in the small forward position.
Wes Johnson, the former number four pick back in 2010. He was a bust in Minnesota, but he shot better in his fourth season. And once he was moved to kind of a small four, like the shooting power forward spot, he really found a niche for himself.
So Johnson hits two of them. And Wesley Johnson has always been impressive physically. Great size, terrific length for a wing, quick off the floor.
Yeah, he's got all of those ingredients, but his ball handling has been a bit mediocre, rather pedestrian, and I think that's held him back offensively.
Bryant gets a wide open look. Gets the front of the rim and out. Stolen by Boozer. Hill passes to Kobe. He feeds it to Johnson. And it's Griffin with the rebound.
I can't feel my shot right now.
Nobody anywhere close to him. Where's the defense? He's got to make that shot, though.
Barnes kicks to Griffin. No luck. And it's the Lakers the other way. Left side, Lynn. Outside, Bryant.
Good shot.
Fades. And good. Got the friendly bounce off the right side of the rim.
It is so hard to contain him. He just seems to get it done however he has to do it.
Paul kicks to Jordan. Runner in the lane. And it's Griffin getting it to go.
That is some real serious dime dropping there. Exquisite assist.
Lynn with it. Outside, Kobe. Johnson in the corner. Another miss by Johnson. The Clippers have gone 1 of 3 from the field to start this one so far. And it's Paul penetrating. Pass to Jordan. It's stolen by Hill. And now here's Johnson, the fast break chance.
They get a hand on it. Hey. And out of bounds as Los Angeles gains possession.
Such a careless pass. You've got to keep your head in the game here.
Are you still downloading stuff for your Xbox?
And it's the Clippers with the ball. Trailing by two. From the wing. The rebound by Johnson.
Man, he needs to worry about making the two, not making the highlight reel. Well, you know, every time these two teams face off, it is Battle Los Angeles. For so long, the Lakers have really owned the city. But the Clippers are looking to make up for lost time right now.
Now here's Griffin. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there. They get Carlos Boozer. And a bit of controversy, guys. Last season, Doc Rivers had the Lakers championship banners covered up for Clipper home games.
I thought it was a smart decision, Kevin. I mean, you got to make it your home gym, and all they did was hang up banners of their own players. A smart move by Doc, and you know, the Clippers will forever be in the Lakers' shadow in L.A., regardless of the results of the games.
Here's Kobe. The shot misses. So Los Angeles will take it the other way. Lynn against Paul. The Lakers with the rebound.
They've had a cold start so far. Just one of five from the floor here early.
And Wesley Johnson with the slam.
A little bit of a magic act here, pulling off the Houdini to make that catch and slam.
Stupendous, stupendous alley-oop.
This crowd just stunned at the sight of that one. Here we go, get it out quick.
Now here's Paul. No scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. Shot clock at six. And he gets it to go.
A good open look, and he splashes home the three.
Outside, Lynn. And Kobe, here we go. And the shot is good. Kobe's got six.
Well, this quarter has gone awfully well for him. It seems like every chance he's gotten, he's pretty much converted.
Got that one up quick.
That is a very low percentage shot, Kevin, but it's the result they were looking for at the end of the day.
Johnson outside. To the right side. Hill sets the screen for Boozer. It's good with the assist that time from Johnson. Boozer's got his first 2 points.
The entire defense was frozen footed. Nobody picked up the shooter, Kevin.
And DeAndre Jordan throws it down.
A good job of spotting his teammate near the basket and zipping the pass right in there. DeAndre Jordan has always had a knack for the incredible, and it usually manifests itself in his dunks or blocks. But last year, he committed himself more on the defensive end, and it really made a difference for him.
Griffin goes in.
Blake Griffin, arguably the top posterizer in the game, but opponents don't like being embarrassed, and they'll take a hard foul on him if need be. Some have said that Griffin needs to retaliate for his own well-being. He's got to go back at some of those guys.
Ties it up, and this next one could give them the lead. And Griffin has said he thought about retaliating for the hard fouls, but he said, Steve, you know, it might be best for me, but getting suspended would be very bad for my team. He had his head on straight, obviously.
Well, yeah, credit him for trying to keep his cool and not get caught up in the moment. But understand that, you know, there's always a two-way street. He oftentimes initiates the contact, and he's such a physical player.
Early morning game.
He's always going to get caught up and tangled up with other players.
Oh, he got a trip.
And out of bounds as Los Angeles gains possession.
That's a major mental mistake. I mean, there's no other way for me to describe it. He didn't know where he was on the court. That's a basic fundamental. You have to be alert to where you are.
Glenn Davis has checked in for Blake Griffin. Farmer dishes to Crawford. Out of bounds, the Lakers will take possession.
like he was surprised to see the pass coming his way, and he reacted a little late.
Lakers trail by three. Nash outside. Feeds to Randall. Out to Nash. From past the arc. They get the rebound. Tries again.
Randall.
And it's Randall getting it to go.
If you battle for the offensive rebound and come up with it, you're guaranteed a high quality shot on the follow, just like he got there.
Thinking like that. Nobody's going to come down.
Now here is Douglas Roberts. Pass to Davis. He dishes it to Douglas Roberts. Six to shoot. Crawford drives in. Count the bucket.
He can finish in the post. That's one thing we know about him.
The Lakers have gone 6 of 13 from the field, just under the 50% mark. Davis setting the pick for Nash. And it's a defensive three-second violation.
You got that zone, dude. You got that zone. That dude right there, big baby. Come to guard somebody.
Lakers shooting their third free throw attempt of the game. And he shows the focus there, nails the technical.
By the way, your feet don't fit no branch. What you hooing about?
.24 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Pass to Henry. Pocket six. Back to Young. It's stolen by Davis. And pushing it up, here's the Clippers.
Let me get what I did, man.
Nash with some nice D.
I kicked
pretty good
whole,
defense there. I mean, that's a shot that he can make, but he really challenged him.
And so that's the end of the first quarter. Offensively, pretty stagnant. Clippers ahead. They're up by two.
I'm not happy.
After this break, we'll be back with the start of the second quarter on 2K Sports. Well, it's been a tight one so far as we get the second quarter going back here. Guys, what's your take on the Clippers so far?
Yeah, this team played an excellent first quarter offensively, moving the ball and getting a good flow to their offense. That's why you see those big assist totals.
Yeah, very timely passing for them, Steve, and that's fun to watch.
The Clippers in the lead. Here are the five the Clippers have to start the second. Clint Davis out there with Spencer Hawes, and it's Crawford, and there's Farmar, and it's Douglas Roberts in at the three spot. Crawford's shot is good.
You know, it wasn't really hard to see why the Lakers struggled so much last year. The talent was down, and also the defensive effort and focus was borderline embarrassing at times.
And the basket by Kobe. The Clippers shooting has been terrific. 54% on the game. Now the dish to Crawford. Pulls up on the elbow. Another one falls for the Clippers.
Right now, Jamal Crawford rolling.
Outside, Kobe. Kicks it to Kelly. Solid play in the low block, and that one's
Kelly.
And the Clippers decide to take their first timeout here.
Get my bench.
And let's now go to the sideline. We'll catch up here with Doris Burke. Doris?
Well, gentlemen, if you ask Coach Doc Rivers about DeAndre Jordan, he's going to say something along the lines of, he can single-handedly change a game with his defense. I genuinely see traits of Bill Russell. Jordan said, to be compared with somebody like that, I take it to heart. Defense is my first, second, and third priority. I know that Doc instilled that in me. Kevin?
There's greatness and respect to be had,
but you know, so
doing the dirty work, Doris. Thank you.
So much of traitors you are. You're right, they are that.
And Los Angeles with some changes. Griffin's checking for Hawks. Barnes comes in for Chris Douglas Roberts. And it's Paul in for Jordan Farmar. Now here's Crawford. 6 points for him. The drive by Paul. Back to Crawford. Three-pointer. Shot is off. And it's the Lakers the other way.
A lot of times when a great player hangs it up, they take some time to find themselves or just relax. But Kobe said last season that he wants to stay heavily involved in the NBA when his playing days are over. Not a huge surprise if you think about just how competitive he is.
And a moment now to look at the scoring approach in terms of where the points are coming from for Los Angeles.
They've been making some really nice passes out there, excellent passing. That could set the tone for the rest of the game.
And I like the physical play we're seeing, too, because this is a club that's really pounding the paint area and scoring inside.
DeAndre Jordan's checked in for the Clippers. Reddick comes in for Jamal Crawford. And the call goes against Wesley Johnson. That's his first foul. And Clark, for Kobe in his post-playing career, you have to think he would like to stay involved with the Lakers on some level, given that he has spent his whole career, really his most formative years with the organization.
You know, that could be true, Kevin, from a front office standpoint, but if he wants to try his hand at coaching, he might have to be open to moving around for a little bit.
Clippers with the ball. After the basket by the Lakers. Here's Paul. Misses off the right iron.
Great defense there. You really have to challenge him at that range.
Here's Johnson. Jordan with the rebound.
Been a poor shooting performance for him today, but luckily for them, he undercut
my guy over
come
there
through.
On the other side. You see it? No, he did. All he did was look at it. You didn't see it, but yeah, he undercut it.
Lakers have gone three of their first five shots to drop here in the second quarter. And Bryant, wide open, he shoots. That's in there, Johnson with the assist. Bryant got the lead up to four now for the Lakers. And he's going up for the alley-oop.
I didn't know you threw the alley-oop. Good work.
And the slam by Blake Griffin.
You can see the eye contact there. Gave a little nod and then burst to the rim for the alley-oop slam.
No doubt, Clark. A pair of teammates with a terrific feel for each other out on the floor.
Mm-hmm. And what a play to make in a close game. A potential momentum builder.
Ryan Kelly. Way to go, Kelly.
And that one's good. Kelly.
It seems that every pass they make is leading to a score here. I mean, that's just exquisite ball movement.
Yeah, they're making the right play. They're working together. They're just looking for the best shot they can every possession.
And it's the Lakers on the break. Johnson's got the ball. Henry misses. Clippers trail by four. Here's Barnes. Good work defensively by Kobe. The Los Angeles Lakers, the NBA's most successful franchise over the last three decades, since 1980. 10, guys, count them, 10 titles.
That's remarkable, and they've led the way from a business standpoint as well, Kevin. They pioneered televising their home games where some teams have worried about undercutting ticket sales. A lot of great ideas and dynamics that have helped this franchise become what it is.
Here's Griffin, and he dunks it down. Lakers have gotten just over 50% of their shots to drop here in the second quarter. They're 5-for-9. The shot by Bryant, no good.
You see the defenders get out of his way a lot of times when he's on his way to the bucket, but not that time.
Knocked loose.
All right.
And is out of bounds to the Clippers as the Clippers retain possession. Big group substitution here for the Lakers. Davis has checked in for Hill. Randall comes in for Ryan Kelly. Nick Young's checked in for Johnson. Nash is subbed in for Kobe. Just five to shoot. Barnes kicks the ball. Barnes can't get it to go.
He hit a three in the first, but so far has been unable to capitalize here in this quarter.
Henry misses.
Well defended, and he's not someone who responds well to that kind of defensive pressure.
Paul with the ball. guarded now by Nance.
Do what?
And the slam by Blake Griffin.
Come on now, did they really just pull that off?
That was an outstanding play.
Yeah, guys, there are alley-oops, and then there are alley-oops.
Nash, the pass to Young. Griffin on the double team. In the corner, Henry with it. Los Angeles with another miss.
Just cannot find the rhythm. Still yet to hit a shot this quarter.
Let's go now to the sideline and catch up with Doris Burke. Hey, Doris.
Thank you, Kevin. Doc Rivers trying to help this Clippers team to the mountaintop. And Chris Paul said, I've never had a coach that wants to win as bad as I do until Rivers. Rivers said, I'm just here to try to win. I always tell our players there's no guarantee to it. You have to be willing to get your hearts broken. Gentlemen.
He's getting him to lay it all on the line. Doris, thank you.
Tell you what, he's going to put that one in his scrapbook. Absolutely insane with that dunk.
Well, now they're starting to rub it in, aren't they? Build up a lead, and here we go, folks. It's showtime.
And why not? I mean, the more plays they make like that, the more they'll have these guys on the ropes.
So timeout called here, the first for Los Angeles.
Well, Griffin, a former dunk contest champion, but make no mistake, Blake is a game dunker, always among the league leaders.
Man.
And at his size with that strength, the way he gets off the floor is just unbelievable.
A platoon swap here for the Clippers.
How much time was left in the half, and I should put my starters back in.
104 left here in the second. And here's Nash. He kicks it to Henry. You know, Blake Griffin gets up so high, he's created some debate, in fact, on the definition of a dunk. So I'll ask, does your hand have to touch the rim?
You know, I think you don't necessarily have to have your hand touch the rim, Kevin, but you do have to throw it through the goal. None of this raggedy type dunk stuff.
Got to control it,
I like that's the word I was looking for. That. Whatever their plan was defensively that time, it didn't work. Not if it results in that shot.
Nash. The shot is off. So the Clippers will take it the other way. There's a 4-second difference from the shot clock to the game clock.
Ball conference
killed. It took him a little while to get into the flow of this game, but now he's definitely found his stride and rhythm.
Last shot.
Shot clock is off. This should be the last possession of the quarter.
That's what they should have in mind here.
Young outside. Poked loose. Back to Nash. A second chance effort. And the release was before the buzzer, but it's off target.
Shut that bad boy.
And so we conclude the first half. Los Angeles on top, ending the second quarter on a 15-4 run. Live from the Staples Center, you're watching 2K Sports.
Frame skip or something, but I don't think it was a connection issue. Oh, no, I'm good. No, I'm just, I don't need to make no difference. Not like that. You need to go, just keep talking to us, man. You need to go to bed yet, man. Come on now. It's only 2:45, man. Come on. Pull on your tongue and put a little bumps on your tongue off. Wait. Hey, Tay. Tay. Chris. Where'd you go to, the Quickie Mart? I got you. Hold on. Yeah, he's... No, I already reset it already. Fucking, you think he had that much time? It's been reset already. I got you. Okay. Yeah.
What?
Jesus, thank you. Yes. Okay. No, I forgot the change that I did there. What's one chance I'm supposed to make? I'm supposed to make adjustment on Crawford. You all right with you? Thank you, sir.
At the second half, beginning in just a moment.
Scott, I don't care what Tate said about you.
Blake Griffin doing all sorts of things. He has 14 points, and he's done his job at the charity stripe. He's gotten 4 of his points from there.
And that's a good place to get them. You know, they don't come easier than that, but you've got to get yourself there first.
Yeah.
And now the third quarter, about to get going. You look at Blake Griffin in this game, he's been everywhere.
Pretty much all throughout that first half, he was just taking care of business down low. And in fact, he had several dunks.
Well, Steve, there's been no defensive effort or resistance down low when he gets the ball in scoring position. That's why he's making it look so easy.
We've got Xavier Henry. Nick Young is up there with Nash. Then it's Randall. And it's Davis at the 5 down low. That's who's in the game for the Lakers. Now, here's Nash. And Davis puts it in.
Well, they certainly didn't have much of a problem getting the ball into the post that time.
Well, that's important because this game, I think, is going to be decided by who controls the paint in crunch time.
Barnes dishes the ball. Let's it fly. The pass to Barnes. Paul kicks to Redick. Good, and Paul gets the assist. Paul's got his 5th assist in this one.
And they've set up countless buckets off assists. That's a huge part of what they've been doing here today.
A lot of dime dropping going on out there, Steve.
Nash drives in. Davis, the pass to Nash. Shot clock at 6. Can't cash in from the high post. Paul kicks to Redick. He's looking for Jordan and finds him. And now it's a double-digit lead. And now a 10-point Los Angeles lead. Here's Henry. And it's going to be 2 free throws. Drew contact on the shot. This is his first free throw of the game. No good on the free throw.
Except they're doing these things on...
Well, you often think of the Clippers as being an updated version of Showtime, but they know how to grind out and get a win, too.
Yeah, I thought they were a little better defensively. They have guys that will certainly give you highlight reel material, but they're smart in how they attack teams and how they finish games, too.
Between shooting a free throw.
Catching up on the changes for Los Angeles. Robert Sacre, he's checked in for Davis. Boozer comes in for Randall. Kobe's checked in for Nick Young. And it's Jeremy Lin in for Steve Nash.
I got it. So
guys, they've had a solid start to the second half offensively. We've gotten good looks. They've made 3 out of 4 of them.
Come on, guys.
Timeout called, the Lakers.
And with the Clippers, I think a big part of how they can grind out a win, if need be, is that they know how to get to the free throw line.
It's
And okay, Los Angeles with some changes.
Everything is set.
Ed Davis is checked in for Sakura.
Let's go.
Hill comes in for Boozer. And it's Johnson in for Xavier Henry.
Well, one way or another, the Clippers, as you said, they'll find ways to score points, even if it means selling a call or two.
Dang, Doc.
Do what you need to do to get wins. Most players are open to that.
Los Angeles calls timeout.
The Lakers might have sunk to the bottom of the Western Conference last season, but they still put up a pretty good fight against a lot of Western Conference teams.
And we're just about 2 minutes into the second half now.
You know, one thing this Lakers group last year always played with was pride. I mean, that should be a given, but that's not always the case. Sure, it was a down year, but they weren't just going to pack it up and give up. Let their bitter rivals have the best of it.
I'd say that shot was well within his range.
You think so? I mean, I was pretty good from 2 feet and in myself. That's a gimme there.
Griffin with it. He's picked up by Hill. And the slam by Blake Griffin.
I tell you what, he can do a lot more damage to that rim than that when he wants to.
And you know, Clark, with the lead they're enjoying, I'm surprised he didn't put a little something extra on that one.
Me too.
Well, I think he did plenty of damage anyway. It was only with one hand, but he threw it down pretty hard.
And that was a silver lining for the Lakers. They did manage to save some face with tough performances.
Yeah, but when it comes down to it, last year was a lost cause for them. Between the injuries and everything, I mean, you can never count the Lakers down for too long in the West. And I think they'll be back, but boy, last year was tough.
And that'll increase their rebound advantage. They've definitely been winning that battle on the board.
Well, the main thing is they haven't allowed many second chance opportunities. And that is always going to allow you to maintain your lead.
And there's the slam dunk to finish it off.
Tell you what, to be successful, this team needs his scoring, and they're really counting on him.
The Clippers look good at the line tonight. They're perfect in four attempts. Griffin no good on the free throw.
Although they didn't end with the best record in the West. No, the Clippers were one of the top teams against the West. And a terrific in-conference record.
Come on, Ron, wake up. When I was late at night, don't do that. That's just stupid.
Third quarter action, and just under 3.5 minutes have gone. Paul goes in. Over to the wing. Dishes to Redick. Good ball movement here by the Clippers. Outside, Davis. The feed to Lynn. And it's Bryant in the corner. Pass to Davis.
You know what happened right there?
Six
I
on
thought
the shot clock.
Still playing center. Heel and pass it right past.
He lobs it up. Oh, a nice defensive play to disrupt the alley-oop. Right side, Lynn. That's tipped. Griffin with the steal. Into Jordan. It's tipped.
Had to bump.
And out of bounds as Los Angeles gains possession. Now, when you think of the great playmakers in league history, John Stockton per game averaged double-digit dimes. Think of this. For his career, 15,806 career assists. A record you knew. Hold up. Right off would stand for a very long time.
And he wasn't really a flashy passer like a lot of the great playmakers you think of, but just always in control. Kind of an old school game, but one that was tremendously successful over the course of his almost two decades with the Utah Jazz.
Now here is Davis. Four on the clock. Looking to end the drought. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. Barnes has got rebound number 5 here tonight. Crawford outside. Here's Davis. And he banks in the layup. They got on this roll a while ago, and they just haven't looked back.
They've done a great job of getting into the middle of that defense and scoring in the paint.
Well, and that's why they're on this run, guys. They're getting the ball inside and getting really high percentage looks.
And the Lakers call time here.
Well, this last season was the Clippers' 30th in Los Angeles. And for a team that's long played in the Lakers' shadow, the second season in a row, the Clippers were the best team in L.A.
Some changes here for the Lakers. Robert Sacre, he's checked in for Davis. Hoosier comes in for Jordan Hill. And it's Henry in for Jeremy Lin. The Clippers also making some changes. Chris Douglas Roberts checked in for Barnes. And it's Farmer in for Paul.
And for the Clippers, in their 30 years in L.A., folks, only 6 times have they finished the regular season with a better winning percentage than the Lakers. Man, it's been domination by the Lakers out there in L.A. land. So Clipper fans are hoping that this is a sign of things to come going forward for their team, the Clippers.
Crawford, no one around him. Offline with his 3. Here's Henry. So the whistle blows on the shot with 2 free throws for the contact right there. And guys, for the Clippers, acquiring coach Doc Rivers from the Celtics in exchange for a draft pick. In Boston, he'd been the 2nd longest tenured coach in the league after Greg Popovich.
Than rebuild, I think he wanted to go for another ring in L.A. He's got a lot of authority, final say on personnel decisions. So Doc has really put his stamp on this team.
And the 2nd free throw, good. We've got 1:23 left to play in the 3rd. Now Farmer. Quiet so far offensively, searching for his 1st points of the game. By himself.
I hate to put it behind the head like that.
Down the breakaway slam.
Yeah, he didn't even bother to wait around for any help on that break.
That was a one-man job all the way, Steve. He knew what to do with it and when.
Crawford's shot is good.
Well, see, that's your
Crawford's
clue, man.
Got 12.
He's created some good opportunities for himself and made the most of them.
Bryant dishes to Boozer. Outside Bryant. Johnson left side. He feeds it to Henry. No good with the triple. Los Angeles leading by 11. Farmar kicks to Crawford. The 10-footer. There's the steal. Johnson goes in. Makes it off the glass. Johnson's got 4 points this quarter.
Another bucket in the paint. That's something they just have not been able to stop today.
I think it's time to make some adjustments defensively, Clark. I mean, what they've got going right now is not getting it done.
There's Crawford with the 3.
Everybody said he ain't got no starters, so why should he have starters? I should say no starters. You're starting light up.
Lakers trail by 9. Taking a look at Los Angeles. CP3 at point with Redick there the backcourt. Blake Griffin down low and DeAndre Jordan. And it's Crawford at the 3. Now here's Kobe. Pocket 6. In the corner, Henry with it. And they turn over the 24-second buzzer, signaling the shot clock violation. Big group substitution here for the Lakers. Davis has checked in for Sacre. Randall comes in for Boozer. Nick Young's checked in for Wesley Johnson. And it's Nash in for Bryant. And the Clippers with a change here, too. Barnes, he's checked in for Jamal Crawford. Paul passes to Barnes. To the left side wing. Six to shoot. Redick with the three. No good. Good defensive work there by Young. The Lakers trade. Here's Randall. Feeds it to Nash. Rebound by the Clippers. They've led by as many as 14 points. Now Griffin inside. Young with the steal. Nash dishes to Randall. Young in the corner. Pass to Henry. They double him with Jordan. There's the dish to Nash. And that one hits back iron.
Defense better not make a habit of giving him that shot. I mean, he doesn't miss many of them.
Griffin can't get it to go in. Lakers trail by nine. Young from outside. Offensive rebound.
He certainly didn't take advantage of the poor defense, but they can't count on him to continue missing.
No, that's for sure, because this guy's too good of a shooter to miss that look consistently.
Well, now they're just going to town on
him. Yeah, you think these defenders would have done a little more to put a stop to that stuff, Kevin, but so far, no go.
Well, a phenomenal aerial assault there, fellas.
And the Lakers call time here. DeAndre Jordan leading the NBA last season in three separate categories, Steve. Rebounding, slam dunks, and field goal percentage.
Yeah, those last two are related, of course. You look at his shot chart, and it's basically a green dot right around the basket. I mean, pretty much all of his attempts coming right at the rim, mostly on putbacks or lobs.
Dang. Okay, there they go.
And it's a completely new group for Los Angeles. Doris Burke has an update for us. Doris?
Something is different.
Yes, during that break, Coach Byron Scott had some words for his team. He was emphatic. We're not getting it done, fellas. We've simply got to step up, get engaged, and try to battle back. Guys, we'll see if the pep talk gets them going.
And thank you for that, Doris. From outside the arc. That one's good, and the Clipper lead is cut down to just 8 points with the bucket from Wesley Johnson.
And for Jordan, last season with Doc Rivers coming in as coach, his role was clearly defined, laid out.
Pissed me off because they thought Johnson back in,
defense and rebound. But Rivers put high expectations within that role, expecting him to contend for Defensive Player of the Year.
Clippers leading by eight. And it's Paul penetrating. And he drops in the layup off the glass.
Well, here we go again. An open path to the hoop, an easy 2 points. Where is the defense? And Jordan playing full starters minutes for the first time in his career last season. Just about doubled his rebounds per game. He's a candidate for most improved player. Come on.
And what do you guys think so far about the offensive approach for Los Angeles?
These long-range shots look like layups out there, guys.
Well, you've also got to love how aggressively they've taken that ball to the basket and scored off dribble penetration.
That one falls, so he hits both of them.
Well, how about Kobe in this one? He has 15 points, and he's created a lot of chances for his teammates also.
And some of these passes have been absolutely beautiful, Clark.
And Griffin, here we go. They retain possession.
Volleyball with you guys.
And in the paint, they have really shown some strength. Their work on the boards has been phenomenal.
Yeah, I'd certainly call it a mismatch, Steve, at least for today.
Now here's Kobe. It's going to be out of bounds. Los Angeles will retain possession.
Bounce from Griffin leg, I think.
And stolen by Redick. They're running. Here's Barnes. hammers it home to polish off the break.
Well, this is how you completely rattle an opponent's rhythm.
Yeah, you know, such terrific on-the-ball defense to trigger the transition opportunity.
And it wasn't just the tough D. It was the exclamation point they put on the fast break with the slam.
Good block.
A bit under 3.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth. Lynn's shot is off.
Looked like he rushed that one, guys. The defense was out of position. He was wide open, just couldn't take advantage.
Paul kicks to Griffin. Stolen by Boozer. Kicks it out to Johnson. Ryan against Barnes. It's good, and the Clipper lead is cut down now to just 10 on the basket from Hill.
God.
Great interplay there between those two teammates.
Paul kicks to Redick. Some nice ball movement by the Clippers. Passes it to Griffin. Stolen by Boozer. Johnson attacking. And there's Bryant. That's good on the assist from Wesley Johnson. Bryant's got it back down to single digits for Los Angeles. And the slam by Blake Griffin.
Man, he slams it home and gets a little camera time on the backside of it.
He spent a while up there on the rim.
I'll tell you what, the refs will give you a lot more leeway on that than they used to.
Still a close game here, though. That's surprising considering they're rarely grabbing any rebounds.
Mm-hmm. That's a good call. That's a good call. There wasn't nothing wrong with that. That was all good. No. That was good. Yeah, I did that. Yeah.
Lynn again. It's Paul.
I don't know if you mean by sitting.
All alone. And he nails the jumper.
Paul's dribbling.
Got 4 points now in the quarter.
Well, there you go.
Oh, okay, I got
you. If you're going to continue to give up open jump shots, you're not going to get back into this game.
And a wide open look for Lynn. The quick look, no good that time. Redick with it. Picked up by Bryant. That's a two from Paul. Great D on that shot, and it's off the mark. Johnson attacking. To the paint. That one's good, and the Clipper lead is cut down now to just 10 on the basket from Kobe.
Really aggressive play, taking it to the rim against the big man.
Tell you what, I love that fearless attitude.
Paul kicks to Jordan. Soft touch off the glass.
You know, it's a plus to get good looks in the paint. And when you can get them, you got to score them.
And the Lakers call time here. They're down by 12. 1:36 left in the fourth quarter.
Damn it. My fault. I should have known it was a 20-second timeout.
1:36 left to play in the final quarter. Lynn the pass to Johnson. Got a piece of it.
Well, he's their top rebounder. He's doing an excellent job on the glass today.
Well, I tell you what, I love the effort he's shown on the boards today, Steve. It's been fantastic.
It's totally outplayed.
And it's out of bounds. The Clippers able to retain possession here.
Got to do better.
Griffin against Boozer.
His touch has disappeared on him this quarter. He just hasn't been able to get it going.
And these are the types of games where it's obvious one team clearly had the edge tonight. It's going to be a great win by a large margin for the Clippers.
Clark, what do you think was the deciding factor in this one?
Simply field goal percentage. They shot the ball much better than the opponent.
You look at the stats and you'll see just how dominant a game this was for Griffin. He was doing everything right, and the points seemed to come in bunches.
Dang, how did that pass?
Definitely had the hot hand.
I've been through the pass. I'm trying to figure out. Seems like by time
he's been anything but his usual self this quarter. It's actually been ugly to see.
Hill gets the rebound. Well, they're really making a point of keeping the ball moving around.
Yeah, Steve and Kevin, you guys got to love this teamwork. I mean, everybody's involved and engaged. It's just a thing of beauty to watch.
Yeah, sure is. And when all five guys, Clark, are threats to score, that makes it so tough on the defense because now you can't account for everybody when the ball's moving so quickly.
Oh, man. Hey, check it out, Chris.
Drop
this
for Hill.
Never seen this.
Or the Clippers.
Look at my stand. These motherfuckers is gone, dude. Look. They are gone.
And he makes both free throws. For Los Angeles, they've gone 7 of 13 from the field here in the fourth.
Man.
Kicks to Douglas Roberts.
2 seconds is on the 405.
Here's Farmar.
I seen an empty. I never seen an empty like that.
So it's Los Angeles winning this one easily. And this one was such a lopsided victory.
They never let up. They were full throttle from the start.
And that about wraps it up for Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke. This is Kevin Harlan thanking you for watching the NBA presented by 2K Sports.
I don't remember.
And now, Jordan presents our player of the game, Blake Griffin.
Yeah, I don't remember seeing it, period. That's what I'm trying to say. Well, you got that series. Shit's gone. Okay, let's play another one here. You still got something up in you? Terrible.